of the excretory system. So excretory system consists of a pair of kidney, a long ureters, two ureters, then urinary bladder and urethra. All the parts I have drawn over here and it is named. If you take kidney is a main part of every parts is very important, but the formation of urine happens. Whatever the urea which is produced in the body, in the liver, is carried to the kidney by the help of blood vessels. Then the urea from the blood is transferred to a kidney. From the kidney, the urine, the formed urine comes to the urinary bladder and urethra is removed. This is the normal process which happens. So we'll go through that step by step, the different steps involved in the formation of urine. Formation of urine. Already I told you, kidney is a main part. So take this, all these parts we know it. Whatever the, so this, see, artery which carries the blood to the kidney. Artery will branch out left and right. And so artery which carries, which comes to the kidney, you know, that will have oxygenated blood. And it contains some of the waste also, urea. That urea is removed by the kidney. And it is transferred to the urinary bladder for the temporary storage. So here there is a ureter by the help of this ureter tube. Then it is removed by the urethra. Understood? So see, lot of blood enters the kidney. But only little amount of urine is pumped and that is removed. So that we will see how it happens to be. So I'll draw the kidney over here. See, I told you kidney has two parts, that is cortex and inner medulla. Inner medulla. Medulla contains pyramid shaped structure. This contains, this inside the medulla and this cortex contains some structure called as nephrons. Our kidney is made up of nephrons. Kidney is made up of millions of nephrons. Millions of nephrons are arranged here inside the kidney. So what is this nephron? Nephron is a structural and functional unit of kidney. It is a structural functional unit of kidney. So see here, so this is the medulla part of the kidney. Here the ureter is there. Here the ureter is there. So whatever the urine is formed in the medulla is carried, transferred to the urinary bladder by this ureter. This ureter, you know it already. So here, an artery will enter. Artery when it enters the kidney, it will branch into smaller arteries. And finally, the capillaries are there. See, we'll draw the structure of nephron. Structure of nephron here. What are the different parts present in the nephron? Let's see. So you can see here this cup shaped structure. This is called as Bowman's capsule. We call it as Bowman's capsule. Chapter Shaped Structure. This structure is called Bowman's Bowman's capsule. See here, this is Bowman's capsule. And if it is this Bowman's capsule, Bowman's capsule it is. See this. This Bowman, after this Bowman capsule, there is a coiled structure. Coiled structure. Can you see this coiled structure? This coiled structure is called PCT. PCT means proximal convoluted tubules. Proximal convoluted tubules. Proximal convoluted tubules. Then followed by one more structure. It's a hairpin. Hairpin-like structure. See, hairpin-like structure it is. So this hairpin-like structure is called a endless loop. Loop. Loop means this structure. Endless loop. Or we call it a loop of Henle. Loop means hairpin structure. Loop of Henle. Then again it is coiled. Then again it is coiled. Again it is coiled. This structure is called DCT. DCT. I write it here. DCT. This structure is called DCT. Distal convoluted tubules. Distal convoluted tubules. It is far away from the this Bowman's capsule. That's why DCT. Proximal, very near. Give pump in between. Then, collecting duct. Collecting duct. Whatever the urine form which is connected here. See, all these nephrons are arranged here. All these nephrons are arranged here like this. All these nephrons are arranged like this. See, this collecting tube. So, all these nephrons are joined and this collecting tube joins to the this structure. This is called hilus. This is called hilus structure. Hilus will you will learn detailed about this structure in higher classes. This is called hilum. Hilum, it is here. All the urine is actually collected. Formed urine is collected. And it is removed. So all these collecting duct units here. And it is like this, millions of nephrons will be present inside the millions of nephrons will be present inside this kidney. That understood, I think. Then I told you one of the arteries enters the kidney and it branches. It branches and it becomes a capillaries also. This, see, the capillaries will enter this structure here. So here, the artery becomes small branches. The small branches of the artery is called capillaries. The capillaries will enter this cup-shaped structure of Bowman's capsule. That the group of capillaries or this capillary tuft of capillary is called glomerulus. You call it as glomerulus. So there is no space to write over here. I'll rub this PCT. Glomerulus. Glomerulus. The stuff of capillary is called glomerulus. So these are the parts of the structure. This is structure of nephron. Nephron means what? It is a structural functional unit of kidney. Nephron is one of the structure found. Millions of nephron is present in the kidney and they actually help in the formation of urine. Nephron, the parts of nephron is Bowman's capsule. The Bowman's capsule is a cup-shaped structure. And in the cup-shaped structure, there is a tuft of capillary. Group of capillaries present over here. That is called as glomerulus. Glomerulus. Then the Bowman's capsule is connected with the tube, coiled tube. Coiled tube. This coiled tube is called as PCT. That is the proximal convoluted tubules. Convoluted tubules. Understood. So this nephron is called as uriniferous, it produces urine. Uriniferous tubules, we call it as. All tubes are there here. Then, here see, this proximal convoluted extended downwards. And it becomes very narrow. Very narrow. That narrow structure is called loop, endless loop. Endless loop. Then again it is coiled, highly coiled structure called as DCT, distal convoluted tubules. Convoluted means coil. Convolutions means what? Coil. Then it is connected to the collecting duct. Collecting duct. These are the structure. See, so when the blood flows in a, so blood flows to the, this glomerulus under high pressure because they are capillaries. So, arteries, this artery of the brain has to come to the high pressure only. When it comes to the high pressure, this area becomes high pressure. Here what happened? All the materials of the blood, all the materials of the blood, it may be harmful material and useful materials, except RBC and large proteins, all other. So, blood is made up of, you know, many of harmful materials are there. And useful materials are there, proteins are there, WBC is there, RBC is there, like that, everything is there. Here, what happens? Blood contains water also. The water with the, some useful materials, minerals, the salts, small proteins, all the good things will be absorbed except the cells. Cells will be not absorbed. All will be absorbed to the Bowman's capsule. Bowman's capsule will absorb all the useful and non-useful liquid materials of the or materials of the blood by the, from the glomerulus. And that which is absorbed by the blood, the glomerulus is called now filtrate. It's called as filtrate. The filtrate is collected over in the Bowman's capsule. Then the filtrates move to the proximal convoluted tubules. Understood? So, whatever the filtration happens here, so in the glomerulus, all the harmful material and useful material is filtrated. And that's called as filtrate. That is called as, that is the first step of urine. That is first step of urine, that is filtration. Call it as filtration. Filtration, ultra filtration happens in the Bowman's capsule. All the useful and harmful materials are absorbed by the Bowman's capsule. Then the filtrates move to the PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. In proximal convoluted tubule, what happens is selective reabsorption happens. Selective reabsorption. Selective reabsorption means, I told you already, here all useful materials and harmful materials are absorbed by the Bowman's capsule from the blood. That is carried. This filtrate is carried to the PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. Here, selective reabsorption happens. Means the good material again they are reabsorbed. Means what, how it is absorbed? We'll see. See here, this. So here is the artery. One of the artery will be coiled like this. It will be coiled like this. Means, this small artery will be coiled in the this tube is, these are tubes, proximal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, and this is distal convoluted tubule. Here it is coiled with this tubules. So here what happens? Here you can see the blood vessels. Here you can see the blood vessels. Here it is coiled. So whatever the good things are there in the filtrate present in the proximal convoluted tubule are reabsorbed. Means good things are reabsorbed. Like sodium salt, water is reabsorbed over here. All the good things, amino acids, are absorbed back to the blood. To the blood. This is called as selective reabsorption. Selective reabsorption. You can see in that page number. You can see here the page number. Page number 77. Structure of nephron. They have given the nephron. So Bowman's capsule they have given. So glomerulus they have given. Tubular parts they have given. Here see one of the artery. One of the artery is coiled with the tubules here. So one of the red color and blue color they have shown. They have shown you shown over here. Means here actually what happens is selective reabsorption. Whatever the good things are present will be absorbed. Will be absorbed back by the blood by the help of these arteries. That will happen. That is called as selective reabsorption. Certain salts like sodium, magnesium, the salts are reabsorbed. Proteins, amino acids. Amino acids are the smallest structures of the proteins that are reabsorbed. All the useful materials are reabsorbed. That is called as selective reabsorption. So here also it is reabsorbed. Loop of Henle also. Then here in the proximal convoluted, sorry, distal convoluted tubules, what happens is here. Secretion happens. So whatever the waste which is there in the blood, again it is secreted back to the back, secreted in the distal convoluted tubule, and that is now is called as urine. That is now is called as urine. After the secretion in the distal convoluted tubule, that filtrate now it is called as urine, which contains urea, and that is carried to this collecting tube, and this collecting tube of all the nephron is dumped in this part called hilus part. So this part, and it is carried to the urinary bladder by the help of ureter. In the urinary bladder, urine is stored, and it is removed by the help of the urethra, and urethra it is removed out of the body. This is how actually the excretory system works, and this is about the formation of urine in human body. So, if you have any doubt regarding this, please ask now. If you have any doubt regarding this. So understood. If you understood the concept, please raise your hand, sir. Otherwise, if you are asking any doubt, please ask in the chat box, sir. So have you understood? So if you understood the concept, please raise your hands. So that means I can move forward to the last concept of the lesson. Means whatever the reduced part. So reduced part. We have finished. So we will conclude the lesson by explanation only the recapitulation of digestive system and respiratory system which you already studied in 8th standard. So because you have studied in the 8th standard, that part is skipped. So that skipped part we will see. Just I will recapitulate it. We will not explain in deep. We will just recapitulate it how it happens to be. Is it clear? So we are moving to the next concept of the lesson, excretion in glands. Excretion in glands. So I hope this you understood. So excretion, I will go on telling the excretion. See, As you know that there is a lot of difference between the plant cell and animal cell. So in the animal cell you have small vacuoles, but in the plant cell we have large vacuoles. And moreover, the difference is that, see, the plant cell, if you take a plant body is made up of dead cell as well as living cells. But animal body is not like that. They have maximum of the living cells. The dead cells are immediately removed. So blood cells are removed. Dead blood cells are removed by the liver. Like that, in our body there are parts which remove the waste material. Nitrogenous waste is removed from the kidney. The air, carbon dioxide is removed from the respiratory system. The undigested food is removed by the digestive system. So heat, the heat is produced, is removed by in the form of perspiration. Like that, we have a lot of organs which are meant for the excretion. Liver is also one of the excretory organs, remember. Because you see, urea is formed in the liver and it is removed by the kidney. So liver is also one of the excretory system. You may be heard about that the drunker, those who drink the alcohol content, the liver that fails. That is because liver will hold all the toxic material for the time being. Understood? So like that we have a separate parts. But plant do not have any excretory system. Whatever the excretory products are produced in the plant body has to be stored in the plant body. Sometimes it is removed also. How it is removed, we'll discuss. So some of the chemicals which are produced in the plant body is stored in the vacuoles. Every plant cell will have large vacuole. In that, all the resins, gums will be stored. You may be knowing that some of the plant, if you injure it, it produces some, it uses some liquids, gums, resins and all. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಧೂಪ ಅಂತ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರಬಹುದು. ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಧೂಪ ಹಾಕ್ತೀವಿ. ಧೂಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು? ಅದು ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಫ್ರೇಗ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಧೂಪದ ಮರನ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ. ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ವೆಸ್ಟರ್ನ್ ಘಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಧೂಪದ ಮರ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಆ ಧೂಪದ ಮರದಿಂದ ನಾವು ಧೂಪ ತಗೊಂಡ್ ಬರ್ತೀವಿ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಈಗೆಲ್ಲ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಧೂಪ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು. ಸೊ ಆತರ ರೆಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಗಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ you know that plants need carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. Whatever the carbon dioxide produced during the respiration is utilized by the for the photosynthesis. So during the respiration, plants also do the respiration. You know that during respiration carbon dioxide is released. And that carbon dioxide actually the plant will be utilized for the photosynthesis. Similarly, during the photosynthesis, oxygen is released. That has to be removed. Small amount is removed from the oxygen is removed from the plant by the help of stomata. The oxygen is removed. So a lot of oxygen is utilized for the respiration purpose. Respiration needs oxygen. This is how the carbon dioxide and oxygen is utilized by the plant bodies, and the excess is removed. And similarly, as you know that leaves get old. When leaves get old, leaves will have a lot of waste materials. Leaves will store a lot of waste material. So after some time, when the leaves get old, they fall off. Wilting process, wilting, we call it as falling off leaves are called wilting. They wilt off, they fall off. When they fall off, when the leaves will fall off, the waste material is removed by this method also. This is how actually the plant removes the excretory products from the body. So go through the textbook. In the textbook it is given how the plants actually remove the waste material from the body. Say even from the roots, So you know that plants, they have roots. Roots are get inside the soil deeply. Surrounding the roots, some of the waste materials is excreted by the help of root also in the soil. That is also done. Like this way, there are many methods of excretion methods in the plant. So this is about the whatever we have studied, reduced part. So the next lesson, next video, we'll see the digestive system, respiratory system, and the photosynthesis. We'll not go into deep. We'll just recapitulate it. I hope it is clear. So you may be knowing about you may be heard about a word called dialysis. Dialysis is a treatment given for a person who have lost his kidney due to some medical reason. His kidney is not working properly, one or both. During this condition, the patient who is suffering from this problem will have dialysis. Dialysis is an artificial method to remove the nitrogenous waste from the dialyzer. Dialyzer is a machine which is used for the dialysis. Dialysis is nothing but it is an artificial method of removing the nitrogenous waste from the blood. So that is known as dialysis. So go through all the concept. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can just ask now. Rashmi has asked what is nodes, lymph nodes. So lymph nodes are the parts of the lymphatic system. So I told you it contains antibodies. I told you itself, a lymph actually help to kill the microorganisms. Means it is a part of our immune system that will help in killing the microorganism, foreign material enters our body. Is it clear, Rashmi?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. If you have any doubt regarding, just ask now. Anybody, if you have any, Pannaga, Anuraga, and Sinchanadi, you are raising your hands. Yeah. Yeah, if you have any doubt now, you can raise your hands over here. If you have any doubt regarding the concept we have learnt. Bhuvana, any doubts? Bhuvana Nayak, any doubts? Any doubt? Arun Kumar, any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Okay. So you need any explanation of digestive system, respiratory system?
No, sir.
So if you need an explanation of digestive system and respiratory system, please, in detail explanation, if you need, you can raise your hands here. So I'm asking to everyone here, those who need the in-detail explanation of digestive system and respiratory system and photosynthesis, please raise your hands. Karnaga,
yes, sir.
Detail explanation?
No, sir.
You tell properly, na? Okay, so we'll do one thing in the next video, next class. What we'll do is we'll just recapitulate. Means we will revise that what you have learnt in 8th standard. I hope you have learnt in 8th standard very well. So that we will, some of you may be forgotten that. We will just recapitulate and we will conclude the lesson. Is it clear? Okay then. So read the test book. Read the test book and we'll recapitulate the other reduced part of the syllabus. Thank you very much.